can't tell you how much it means to have all of you here with us tonight for this event. There's people literally all around the world that are watching what has been happening here in Milwaukee, and it really touches my heart to see the kind of compassion and response that people have had to this event. So some of you may be noticing some of the differences, if you haven't been to Kirtan before, with this from regular kinds of radio songs. When I go out to LA for the music conventions out there, I find it fun to make note of the things that people would say about our music. So I play them a Kirtan song, and some of the critiques come back as, the lyrics are so repetitive. It is a chant. And your songs, they're so long. Which might be a compliment, I'm not sure, but I've tried to gather some of those statements because those are the exact reasons why we do this music. Just as if you're trying to get exercise for the body, you wouldn't go for a 2-minute jog or a 3-minute, maybe some of you would. But you want to get the heart rate up, you want to get the sweat going, you want to go 15, 20 minutes for a jog to really get that full effect on the body. And the same thing with the kirtan music, they say it's like cleaning the mind, that it creates grooves in the mind by doing something repetitive over and over. And every sacred tradition in the world has the practice of repetitive sounds. Whether it's doing rosary, doing a mala, doing whatever tradition you come from, this idea of doing something that has a repetitive vibration, because it's like rocking a baby. You create these grooves. It soothes the mind. It creates peace. And brings you back to your center. So we had a number of requests for this particular song from some people who I know as well as those who I don't, who probably knew that this is a song that you would do. It's the Maha Mantra, and many of you have heard it before. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Now, the second part is Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Before you go running out of the hall because you're going to say Krishna, let me tell you what the word actually means. The words aren't up there, but you all know this mantra, right? You don't need the words for this, I don't think. If you do, raise your hand and we'll make you sit right here. On stage with us. Krishna. Krishna is a Sanskrit word. Krishna comes from the word kristihi, to draw to. And Krishna, the word Krishna, has to do with love. I know a lot of you, you know, there might be some dubious airport kinds of memories for some of you. But when you looked at those people that were trying to, entice you by chanting, what they were doing at that point, because they call themselves Hare Krishnas, the idea of being intoxicated with that love of the divine, that is what that group is about. And so that's one way of understanding it. The other way of looking at Krishna is drawing to you, because they say that when you're in love with something, and when someone loves you, it's hard not to be drawn to that person. Here it's just a natural response. You want to go to those people who adore you. And love tends to draw that in. So that's what this chant is about. And Hare, the Hare at the beginning, has many different meanings, one of which is to get rid of everything else, to toss away, except for Krishna, the love. And Ram, 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 Ram. Ram is that dharma we say, or the right path, taking the right actions. So in chanting this, I invite you to just contemplate what that might mean in your life, with how that might come out. And feel free to join in or any way that you'd like to. Hare Krishna.